On a busy street of Taimani in the northwest of Kabul, one would see plenty of fruit sellers lined up along the streets. Just that as you drive along the street, one among the fruit sellers there wasn't in this business until 2 weeks ago. Nazar Mohammed was an assistant professor at the Kabul University at the Faculty of Fine Arts. Afghanistan's dire economic condition has forced him to take up selling bananas as a profession. He graduated from the Kazakh College of Fine Arts in Kazakhstan. Nazar, a father of two, lives in a joint family of 12. He is not accustomed to selling bananas.
I don't know how to sell, how to contact with the people who want to buy this banana. Because of that, I think it is really hard for me.
Nazar believes that this time won't last forever, that he tries to be contented because it's his family who have suffered the most during the hard period.
If I wasn't happy, what should I do? Nothing. Really, it's hard, but I am trying to be happy. But maybe suffering my family because of this, more than me. Suffering my family is my friends. They're calling me, why the, like this happened to you, to those scholars that are working in universities, their lecturer, like this. It is a big problem. But I'm feeling that this is good, but it is not permanent. Maybe it will, this situation go, we will change the future, it will be changed.
Afghanistan is currently battling a number of issues that includes corruption and a cash crunch. But it's people like Nazar who are clear examples of living life with dignity. From being an educator to selling bananas, Nazar says that when he goes back home, he is happy and contented that whatever he's taking home is with his hard-earned commitment to whatever he's doing.
Only 5% of Afghan households reported having enough food to eat, according to recent World Food Programme surveys. Teachers continue to not be paid in Afghanistan for months now, and Nazar is not the only one. In Kabul's Bibi Maharo area, it's 9 a.m. on the dial as Asan, who used to be a teaching assistant at a private university, is leaving his house. Only to go to his usual spot at a busy street of the city center called Shehr-e-Nau, where he is now washing cars to run his family.
Teachers cannot. I will be help with there. Now I'm the society and the Afghan society is very bad. I know, and I'm washing the car and I get the money because I have to. Because I have a children, I have a family, I have a wife. I have to work that.
Ahsan says it's difficult for him to live. He now earns 10 times lesser than he used to earn before. He believes that in the Taliban rule, there might be peace, but there is no place for professionals.
Government, last minute, Ashraf Ghani is bad because we don't have any job. What now is Taliban is good, but not find a good job. Because it's still half of the Emirate, Islamist pupils. We don't need to me. Never need me? What way do you hear?
In August, the Taliban overthrew the US-backed regime and declared an interim government, vowing to restore stability. But the Taliban still face a range of international sanctions and a campaign of bloody attacks by the Daesh terrorist group. While climate change has made Afghanistan's droughts more frequent and intense. By early next year, it is projected that 97% of the population in Afghanistan will be under the line of poverty, with Taliban continuously insisting and requesting skilled professionals to stay in the country, while the country continues to face an acute shortage of cash and other essentials. The treatment rendered out to educators would need more than just statements to hold them back as they strive to earn with dignity and hard work.
At least 18,000 teachers in Afghanistan, including 10,000 female teachers, have not been paid for the past 4 months. Most of them have been selling their home equipment for a while to keep themselves running, but now they don't have anything to sell. Teachers and assistants like Ehsan are now forced to do odd jobs like these in order to keep their household running and earn with dignity. Anas Malik in Kabul, Afghanistan, for WION, World is One.
WION is now available in your country. Download the app now. Get all the news on the move.